In a previous video, I looked at this R1R2 link and suggested when carrying out the continuity CPC test in a college environment, it will make your life easier by clipping onto the earth bar, the crocodile clip, and using the magnetic end to sit on top of your circuit breaker of the circuit under test. Then it rose a few questions. The first one being, is it going to be able to get onto an RCBO? So I tried it on the Lewden one. The Lewden have got a large connection for their RCBO and it fitted comfortably onto that. I tried it onto a Wylex AFDD, which has a lot smaller terminal, it fits on there. And obviously we just linked to that earth bar. And I also tried it on an MCB from Wylex that had quite a deep terminal. So in other words, it had to go in quite a long way in order to get the magnetic tip to touch. And in all three cases, it worked perfectly well. The other question I got asked was, will it add a lot more to the resistance? Because this will only just touch onto the terminal. So as we go on like so, that's just held on by the magnetic element of it. So today I'm going to see if it adds much to the resistance to answer that question. I've got a bit of a rig set up here. So I like to put the line conductor under test in the earth bar with the CPC and go out into circuit. To make my circuit realistic and long, I've got these two drums of cable here. And we're going to measure the resistance of them, linked like so. Then I'll bring my RCBO in and I'll put my line connection in there and I'll redo the test using the R1, R2 link to see if it makes a massive difference. Right, so setup wise, first of all, we're going to need to remove the resistance of our leads. So what we got there? And yep, so that's sitting at zero, so it's not flashing. Remember, if it's flashing, it's gone below zero. I've got them linked together in the consumer unit. I walk out into my installation, I'm going to test between my CPC and my line connection, and I've got a reading of 1.75 ohms. So when I now put an RCBO in place, it'd be interesting to see what that new reading would be with the link in place. So I drop my line connection out of my earth bar, and I'm going to just pop it into the top of my Wylex one, because that's got a lot smaller termination in there, and that was one of the concerns. So if I pop it into there, and I'm going to tighten that down as if it was in situ. Make sure it's nice and tight. I haven't got a Torx screwdriver, but I will just do it firmly up. Okay, so it would normally be using a Torx screwdriver in order to get it back to required manufacturer's Torx setting. So we can just pop that onto there. We can now test between these two points here, remembering we're going to need to remove the resistance of the link. So let's do that next. So I clip onto my link, and then we see what we've got there. Press my test button once, press it again, it's zero, so it's not flashing zero. So we got 1.75 last time. Drop it on there with our magnetic connection onto our earth bar, so our link is in position. Back out into the installation, onto our CPC, and onto our line connection. And let's see what reading we get. And we've got a reading of, we've got 1.8. Okay, so a fractionally different reading there. Is it enough to cause you any concerns? That's a decision you're going to have to make. But in a college setting, this link is absolutely brilliant from the point of view, the amount of times the terminal on top of the MCB, or in this case, RCBO, has to be undone, taken out and put in an earth bar and done up in order to carry out your continuity test. For me, in a college setting, the fractional difference there on the reading wouldn't cause me any concern. So we look back, yeah, it's about 0.04, 0.05 of an ohm difference. So that's something you're going to have to make as your own personal decision if you end up getting these. I am not being paid to make this video. There is no benefit to me if you go out and buy one of these. I will leave a link to the gentleman's website in the description. So if you decide you want to get one, it will be personally your choice. But from a college point of view, I think these are fantastic. These R1, R2 links will mean that those screws do not get damaged. But as always, I hope this video has been some help.